Last year, over on the Cyber Mentors channel, I made a video explaining why you should avoid using OR 1 equals 1 in SQL injections. I also wrote a blog post and later added a section to my cheat sheet. OR 1 equals 1 is really a placeholder for any OR true payload. It just happens to be the go-to payload many SQL injection guides use. There were three main examples I used to justify my reasoning. The first was that when used as part of a login bypass, it would return all rows of the users table instead of just one user, which is generally speaking what the login process is looking for, and therefore despite being a valid injection, would ultimately cause the login bypass to fail, potentially leading to a false negative result. The second example imagined a case where there was a large table of data, and the OR 1 equals 1 injection would cause the database to load all of that data into memory instead of a few rows as expected. This could potentially cause issues where either the application or web server itself couldn't handle processing the data being returned. The final example challenged people's assumptions about where their injections were occurring. People usually assume that their SQL injection is going into a select statement, and this may be the case in most instances. However, it's not a rule, and the injection may occur in an update or delete statement instead. In these cases, an OR 1 equals 1 injection would cause a mass update or delete of data in the table, which could have catastrophic effects for the web application. In all these examples, you could instead use what I call a valid value, along with an AND 1 equals 1 payload, and easily detect an SQL injection in a safe and controlled manner. A valid value is simply any value you would use normally as part of the application functionality that actually returns a positive result. For example, if you're testing a username field, you would start with a valid username instead of just immediately injecting your payload into the field. This valid value is usually all you need, and if you don't have one, you can usually just ask the customer for one or enumerate the application and find one manually. If you're unable to obtain a valid value, the AND 1 equals 1 injection does not work because the AND operator requires both conditions it's testing to be true, and an invalid value will always be false. In these instances, an OR true payload is usually required to properly detect the SQL injection, which is why I always previously said it should only be used as a last resort. However, recently I was introduced to an OR-based payload which didn't require a valid value and didn't pose a danger to the web application. So in this video, I'll be demonstrating it, explaining how it works, and also showing how a few similar payloads were discovered by myself and another. Before we get into that, hello and welcome to my channel. I'm Tiberius, and if you're new here, I cover mostly web application security focused topics, having worked as a web app pen tester for over a decade. If you enjoy the video, please consider giving it a like, subscribing to the channel, and of course, leaving a comment to let me know what you thought. Something to note before we get into these payloads, and which usually gets brought up when OR true dangers are mentioned. Yes, if you end your payload with some kind of limit clause, like a limit 1, that can prevent a lot of issues I mentioned previously. However, limit clauses go at the end of an SQL statement, and there are scenarios where we need to inject into the middle of a statement and cannot just comment out the rest. So, for sake of argument, we're going to assume that's the case here, that we cannot just use comments or limits to otherwise affect the statement we're injecting into. Coffin, who uses the handle CoffinXP7 on X, shared this MySQL payload. Now, this was originally designed for bypassing WAFs, but we can turn it into a simple time-based inferential payload. Let's test this out by using a site like dbfiddle.uk, which allows us to create a temporary table and play around with various queries. I recommend using dbfiddle.uk and sqlfiddle.com if you want to learn more about SQL and SQL injections. So we have a users table containing three rows. If we do a select from users where username equals an empty string or where 1 equals 1, all three rows will be returned as expected. However, if we use the new payload, we see that only the first row is returned. So the payload works, but why? Let's break it down. This if function takes three arguments, a conditional check, a value to return if the condition is true, and a value to return if the condition is false. In this case, if the condition is true, the sleep function is executed for 1 second and returns a value of 0. If the condition is false, a 1 is returned. This returned value is then compared to a 0. So effectively, a true condition here will result in an OR 0 equals 0, which is an OR true. We know that only the first row is being returned, so whatever this condition is, it must only be true for the first row and no other. The condition simply checks if the return value of the now function equals the return value of the sysdate function. Checking the documentation, we can see that the now function returns the time at which the statement began to execute, and the sysdate function returns the time at which it executes. Why this comparison only returns true for the first row is actually really clever. Remember, the if function is going to be evaluated for every single row in the table, one by one. On the first row, the return value of the now function and the return value of the sysdate function are the same, since the statement has just begun to be executed. That means the sleep function is run for 1 second and we get an OR 0 equals 0, which is true, and the first row is therefore returned. All good so far, but something different happens when the second row is evaluated. Remember, the database just slept for 1 second, but we're in the middle of executing a statement, so the return value of the now function is no longer equal to the return value of the sysdate function. In fact, it's 1 second behind. This means a 1 will be returned by the if function, resulting in an OR 1 equals 0, which is false, and so the second row is not returned. More notably, however, the sleep function is not called, nor will it ever be called again, because it is temporally impossible for the now function to ever equal the sysdate function again for the duration of the statement execution. This means the injection works with an invalid value, only returns the first row of results, and only ever sleeps for 1 second. Pretty cool, right? An OR true, kinda payload that doesn't come with the usual risks. It is a time-based payload, so it does unfortunately still take time to perform enumeration with it, but no payload is perfect. It also only works on MySQL and database variants derived from MySQL like MariaDB, which got me thinking, could we find similar payloads for other databases? The answer is yes. After reading over the Postgres documentation for date and time functions, I found this. At a fundamental level, it works in exactly the same way as the MySQL payload. Instead of an if function, we have to use the case when syntax. And as it turns out, the Postgres date functions measure to the nearest microsecond, meaning they won't ever be equal when being evaluated. So instead, I simply subtracted the result of the now function from clock underscore timestamp and check whether it's less than a second. If it is, the PG sleep function is called to sleep for 1 second. Now, unfortunately, the return value of the PG sleep is void, which can't be used in comparisons. So we need to concatenate it with a string, in this case 1, which we then compare to a 1 in order to make the OR true. For every other case, we return a string 0, and this clearly doesn't equal 1, so every other row will be evaluated as false. Moving on to Oracle, and Richard Moore over on X noted that Oracle has a rowNum pseudo column, which means every row of the results from a query is assigned a unique incrementing index number starting at 1. So actually, the Oracle payload is perhaps the simplest. SQLite is very similar as it has a row ID pseudo column. However, this will be disabled if the table was created using the without row ID syntax, so it's not guaranteed to work. I did also try to find one for Microsoft SQL Server, but failed. So I guess it's time to issue a challenge of sorts. Can you find an injection which uses some form of OR true, yet only ever returns the first row of results without relying on limit clauses? Obviously, the injection I really want to see would be the one which works for Microsoft SQL Server, but a more reliable SQLite one would also be welcome, and of course, if anyone can find shorter or even just different payloads for other database variants, please let me know. I'll be updating my SQL injection cheat sheet with the examples I've gone over in this video, and we'll add any that are found, with proper credit being assigned, of course. If you enjoyed this video, please remember to give it a like, subscribe to the channel, and leave a comment with your thoughts or, hopefully, a cool SQL injection payload you've found. Happy hunting!